Good morning, good morning. Welcome and welcome back to Escape Forever Free. I'm your girl Faith. Here we are teaming together one more time to work towards restoring physical, mental, spiritual, and social wholeness. This is our 1 hour alone time kickstart devotional guide aimed at helping us to build that healthy habit of spending at least 1 hour with God every single day. So we invite, of course, if you don't have this routine, to powerfully consider subscribing to our channel to get support in building this very necessary and very important habit. We invite you to further peruse the rest of our channel to see the week's servings that we have delivered for this week. So this is now our 1 hour alone time kickstart devotional guide time, and we're going to go into that as we also consider Sabbath preparation, which begins today, Friday. Let us pray and go into our routine. Holy Father, thank you so much for your gift of love and your gift of life. Please go before us now as we seek after truth and light concerning the state of the dead. Make clear to our understanding all that is revealed today, Father, and we pray that your Holy Spirit will be our master teacher as we read and as we listen to the knowledge that is coming forward in this presentation. In Jesus' name we pray, with hope and thanksgiving. Amen. All right, so we're going to go into our memory text right now. We've been trying to recite, to practice John 11, verse 25 and 26. And now we're going to attempt to recite it. John 11, 25 and 26. Jesus said unto her, I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die. Believest thou this? Again, John 11, verses 25 and 26. Jesus said unto her, I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. 26. And whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die. Believest thou this? I hope we did get it right. Let us read it and see if we did get it correct. It says, John 11, verse 25 and 26. Jesus said unto her, I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. 26. And whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die. Believest thou this? I think we did get it correct. And if we didn't in any place, we pray God give us the power to continue to practice and the power to remember it in due season to glorify his name. Let's go straight into our reading now. We're going to pick up at page 554.1 of the Great Controversy. Of course, we're in chapter 34 entitled Spiritualism. So let's begin 554.1. Satan beguiles men now as he beguiled Eve in Eden by flattery, by kindling a desire to obtain forbidden knowledge, by exciting ambition for self-exaltation. It was cherishing these evils that caused his fall, and through them he aims to come past the ruin of men. Let's read Genesis 3 verse 5 in reference to this matter. Genesis 3 verse 5 reads, For God doth know that in the day ye eat thereof, then your eyes shall be open, and ye shall be as gods, knowing good and evil. Back to the pages of the controversy. Spiritualism teaches that man is the creature of progression, that it is his destiny from his birth to progress even to eternity toward the Godhead. And again, each mind will judge itself and not another. The judgment will be right because it is the judgment of self. The throne is within you, said a spiritualistic teacher, as the spiritual consciousness awoke with him. My fellow men all were unfallen demigods. And another declares, any just and perfect being is Christ. Now, thus in place of righteousness and perfection of the infinite God, the true objection of adoration, in place of the perfect righteousness of his law, the true standard of human attainment, Satan has substituted the sinful, erring nature of man himself as the only object of adoration, the only rule of judgment or standard of character. This is progress, not upward, but downward. It is a law both of the intellectual and the spiritual nature that by beholding we become changed. The mind gradually adapts itself to the subjects upon which it is allowed to dwell. It becomes assimilated to that which it is accustomed to love and reverence. Man will never rise higher than his standard of purity or goodness or truth. If self is the loftiest ideal, he will never attain to anything more exalted. Rather, he will constantly sink lower and lower. The grace of God alone has power to exalt man. Left to himself, this course must inevitably be downward. We will stop there for today, my friends. We're going to go now into our meditational hymn 522. My hope is built on nothing less. We will do stanza 4 together this morning. When he shall come in trumpet sound, oh, may I then in him be found, clad in his righteousness alone, faultless to stand before the throne. On Christ the solid rock I stand, all other ground is sinking sand. All other ground is sinking sand. My friends, let us pray that we truly stand upon the solid rock as we continue to understand these truths and make the adjustments that our convictions require of us concerning the state of the dead and the state and the destiny of the righteous versus the wicked. Let us pray. Holy Father, we thank you so much for another week together. And as we come now into preparation day, we ask of you, Holy God, to please help us to prepare ahead, Father, as much as we can, to be ready for the Sabbath always when they begin Friday at sunset. And may we be able to keep them holy through your Holy Spirit empowerment all the way through Sabbath, Saturday at sunset, even according to Isaiah 58, Father, so that we may even reap the benefits that are promised there. Father, we pray that you go before us today and you give us, Father, the portion of your Holy Spirit and your guidance and your leading that we will need to live today perfectly. May your angels remain with us as our guardians that you have appointed. And Father, may we, Father, be so in tune and connected with you so that we can actually know when they are prodding us to stay out of temptation. Father, we pray that you'll just keep us holy, pure, fully surrendered, and faithful. In Jesus' holy name we pray with hope and thanksgiving. Amen. Let the words of our mouths and the meditation of our hearts be now and always acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. My friends, happy Sabbath to you and yours when it begins on sunset on Friday, wherever in the world you are, and whatever time sunsets on Friday come in. And also, may you keep it holy all the way. All of us keep it holy all the way through sunset on Saturday. Wherever in the world you are at sunset on Saturday and whatever time the sun sets on Saturday at that part of the world that you find yourself. God bless you and happy Sabbath when it comes. God's willing, we will meet again next week for more Escape Forever Free time together. God bless you and please remain faithful as you follow the Holy Scriptures, our roadmap into New Jerusalem and eternal life. Happy Sabbath. God bless.